Yes, ATV radiators can be fixed. Today we're repairing a YFM 660 Grizzly Yamaha 2000 ATV radiator with a puncture in it. We're using oxyacetylene and superalloy 5 to make the repair.
We're just going to heat up around the hole just so we can make the temperature about the 600 degrees we're looking for before we go in. The reason why we do this is because aluminum will really suck that heat out. Aluminum's a funny metal to work with. And we're going to heat up the end of the rod just so we can get some flux on it. And then we start laying our flux in with the heat. Always use the heat to lay your flux in, and then the rod will follow the flux. All right, we're getting there. See how easy this is? You just let the flux do its job. Alright, oh, there we go. Build a little bridge across here. And the reason why we're using the oxyacetylene instead of propane, because the propane will almost get to the right temperature, but the oxyacetylene, you can turn it down and work it at a temp. And if you need more, then you just build up, you put a little more oxygen and just start building up with your rod and flux, because you have the right amount of heat. And just going to flow this out flat. Grab a little more flux. You can just keep building and keep building and keep building if you wanted to. I mean, we're just fixing the hole. You see it was in a crash. And you just saved yourself a few hundred dollars making that repair in what, 45 seconds, a minute?